Welcome to Tekzilla Bites, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Patrick Norton, and we love the Raspberry Pi here on Tekzilla, so we were thrilled when the new B-plus model showed up in the mail. It's the first new model from over 2 years from the Pi Foundation, and despite including a number of improvements, it sells for the same $35 MSRP, if you can find it for sale for that price. Like the original Raspberry Pis, supplies a little short, so prices are going up. Bunch of new features in here. Is it time to dump your Raspberry Pi Model A or B? Let's compare the two. So, this is the Raspberry Pi B Plus. It's a touch more compact than previous models, and the first thing you might notice is another pair of USB 2.0 ports, bringing the total to four, which is awesome. You can now run a mouse, keyboard, and a Wi-Fi dongle and hard drive without needing an external hub. All the USB ports are now flush with the side of the board, and while you might think the composite video out is gone, it's actually been built into the 3.5mm audio jack. You're going to need a special dongle to get your analog video on, but the HDMI port is still there. The SD card slot has been replaced with a micro SD card slot, which means no more fears of breaking your SD card or ripping the socket loose, a common fear, at least around here, because Michael has actually managed to rip two of them loose in real life. And the micro SD card clicks in place for a secure mount, which is a nice touch, and no more hanging over the edges. Now, the biggest upgrade you can probably see on the board is the extra GPIO pins. There are now 40 up from the 26 pins on the original Model B. The same pinout is used for the first 26 pins, so existing devices are compatible, but Adafruit says you'll need a downgrade GPIO cable that goes from 40 to 26 pins to use your existing gear. Otherwise, the B Plus uses the same camera, DIS display connector, and HDMI port. One last thought before we talk about internal upgrades, there are now four squarely placed mounting holes, which helps with the aesthetics, as do the new rounded corners. I don't know if I had a problem with square corners, but people seem to love those sanded off rounded corners. Now for the upgrades you can't see by looking at the board. First up, a switching power supply has replaced the linear regulators in the original design. This is cool. That means power consumption goes down by somewhere between a half and 1 watt. This could mean the difference between getting all your USB devices to work consistently versus needing a powered hub. That power change, it's got another advantage we'll talk about in a minute. Now, while we're talking power, the Pi Foundation says a new dedicated low noise power supply makes for much better audio. The onboard audio circuit still is an audiophile grade as far as I'm concerned, but it is a tad cleaner. So, what hasn't changed about the Model B from previous models? I'll tell you about that in a second, but if you're looking to learn more about Linux, programming, or well, any of a couple thousand different subjects, you should check out our sponsor, lynda.com/Tekzilla. Get yourself a free week of learning online via video you can access anytime, anyplace, at your own pace. It's good stuff. Not so good stuff on the Raspberry Pi? Well, I, for one, was way disappointed that the B Plus has the same Broadcom BCM2835 system on a chip, which includes an ARM 700 megahertz processor, the same 512 megabytes of RAM, the same Ethernet adapter, so there's no gigabit Ethernet. So if you're looking for a mad performance boost for your existing Raspberry Pi builds, well, you might try overclocking the B Plus. I've read online that folks have had good luck overclocking with the B Plus's more efficient power supply, but there's no boost from the actual processor itself. On the upside, since they didn't change that system on a chip, you should have zero issues running any existing Pi build on the B Plus. And if you're looking to clean up your existing Pi projects, the extra ports on the B Plus means less stuff on your desktop, so you'll have to build or buy a new box that'll fit the B Plus because, hey, it's a new design. Now, as far as we're concerned, the B Plus is going to be our go-to board if we need to buy a new board for projects. As far as the Raspberry Pi Foundation goes, this is, quote, the final evolution of the original Raspberry Pi, end quote. We suspect that means the new CPUs and memory will be coming in the Model C, or whatever they call it, but of course, we have no date for when that might arrive. Looking for a good Raspberry Pi project, a free NAS build, or maybe you want to learn how to tune up your car or make bacon? Check out our other show, Die Tryin'. I'm Patrick Norton. Thanks for watching this episode of Tekzilla Bites.